right now we're getting over a little later at a winter now, which is a good timing for us to do a program, because when we remove these coyotes, yep. they won't be filled back in until your fawns get up a little bit older.
Okay.
So a lot of places I go, we do like 3 times a year.
Okay.
We hit them during the fall when the pups start dispersing, because then you've got big movements going everywhere.
Yeah.
Have a real widespread impact doing that. Then we'll hit them again during breeding season, right before they have pups, you know. And then after that, we'll do it again during fawning. So that's the 3 critical time periods that we do. But if you're in a state where you can only do one, if you only have time for one, and you're wanting fawn recruitment, obviously you want to have traps on the ground right before your fawns are born. You remove those coyotes, and you're not having a lot of movement. Coyotes are trying to raise their pups, too. So they're not moving much. Whatever you remove then are your resident coyotes that live and hunt on your property, basically.
And it's nice here where you have the ability to remove them right before fawns hit the ground, because there's a lot of states you can't. And that's right. unfortunate, because, you know, they rebreed so fast and repopulate, but being able to get them there, and so you did perfect having Clinton here now, because he's right, you know, fawns are most vulnerable at first about 6 weeks of life.
Yep.
So if they can get past that, you know, they can do a pretty good job avoiding a lot of the coyotes. So,
yep.
yeah, so everyone you remove now is going to make a much bigger difference on numbers of fawns they're going to eat than at other times of the year. So timing is very important. At QDMA, we monitor this around the country, all the different states, you know, the fawn recruitment rates and how they change over time. And literally, back in 2000, which wasn't that long ago, on average, a fawn or a doe recruited about 0.89 fawns per doe. So almost one. You know, and people think it's a lot more because they see does with twins, but that's the number that actually survived a fall. Today, that number has dropped all the way down to 0.66 fawns per doe.
Wow.
So really, across the country today, it takes 3 does to recruit 2 fawns into the deer herd. I mean, that's a big deal. And you know, all those fewer fawns coming in, that means as hunters, we get to kill fewer deer.
Mm-hmm.
So it's fewer bucks being pumped into the system, it's fewer antlerless deer, you know, to feed our families. So that's why it's important to start looking at these programs, say, hey, what is really going on? Because there's some states that still recruit a lot of fawns, but that's why it's good to look at right where you are and say, okay, what's really happening? So that's where the data collection comes in, you know, and monitoring fawns per doe and all that. And then, but it's important to continue to do that, just like you want to keep, you know, having coyotes trapped every year and removing. So really there's 2 pieces of data to keep. Every fall when you're hunting, keep track of numbers of bucks and does and fawns you see. You know, it's free, it's fun, you're already there, it doesn't even take any extra time, but that's what really allows you to know, hey, is this working or not? Then also from the coyote end, it's important to monitor and keep data on coyotes that are caught. You know, like how many, you know, how long did we trap to catch X number of coyotes, and were they males or females? You know, how much, it's nice to weigh them, you know, so we know, are they juvenile males, you know, that's really expanding, or are we catching more resident females? So just on what he actually catches gives you a pretty good idea of really what's going on here on the ground. So, well, you know, a little bit of data collection, which is very simple to take and very easy to get and doesn't cost you anything, goes a long, long way, and you know, in the long-term management plan for what you want to do here.
You can't completely measure your predator program just by how many coyotes we catch.
Yeah, you know, they're all like little pieces of a puzzle. Each little piece doesn't show you much of the picture, but as you add more of those together, suddenly it becomes pretty clear what it is. And then that just allows you to be way more effective as a manager to get to what your goals are and where you want to be.